Hello friends, welcome to the video on triangles. In the previous video, we discussed about the congruence of triangles. Today, taking a step forward, we will discuss about the criterion for the congruence of triangles. The first criterion is side angle side. Friends, when two triangles are congruent, then there is one-to-one correspondence between their sides, angles, and vertices. But, with the help of some sides and angles, can we prove two triangles to be congruent? In this video and in the upcoming video, we will see at least how many sides or angles must be equal for two triangles to be congruent. Friends, in triangle ABC and triangle PQR on the screen, both the sides AB and PQ are 6 cm and sides AC and PR are 7 cm. So will two triangles be congruent if the two sides of any two triangles are equal? Friends, will the third side also be equal? It may or may not be equal. That is, just two sides being equal is not a sufficient criterion for the congruence of triangles. So friends, can you tell under what circumstances can the third side of these triangles be equal? You can also pause the video for thinking. If the angle made by these two sides are equal, then will the third side also be equal? Due to the angles being same, the open portions of the other side of these sides will also be equal in length. And then we can say that these two triangles are congruent. That is, if a triangle's two sides and their included angle are equal to another triangle's two sides and their included angle, then the two triangles are congruent. This is called side-angle-side or SAS criterion. Can two triangles be congruent with lesser conditions? For example, one side and one angle of two triangles are equal. Here are some examples. Here, the triangles are not congruent by just having one equal side and one equal angle. Friends, apart from SAS, are two triangles congruent by the SSA rule, wherein two sides and one angle of a triangle which is not within these sides are equal to the sides and one angle of another triangle? By looking at the figure, we can tell that these two triangles are not congruent. Therefore, SSA cannot be accepted as the test for the congruence of triangles. Friends, the SAS congruence rule cannot be proved with the help of previously known results. Therefore, it is accepted as true in the form of an axiom. Why don't you do an activity? Cut two triangles from a paper in such a way that the two sides and the included angle of one triangle are equal to the two sides and the included angle of the other triangle. And then look at the two triangles by stacking them one on top of the other. Are they fitting exactly one on top of the other? Check. Friends, that's all in today's session. Today we studied the SAS criterion for the congruence of triangles. See you in the next video. Thank you.